today is the funeral party.
It's a living funeral for my 65th birthday. Nobody I'd rather plan my funeral with except Christina.
No one I'd rather plan your death with than you.
You can pull up right here.
Yeah, no.
I'm so stressed.
So am I. Okay, here goes nothing.
Got that?
Got it.
Check, got it.
Yeah, we really couldn't do anything in advance because they had a funeral. But I think we'll get it together.
I hope so.
One day, Christina made a joke because I don't like flowers. And she goes, you know, you don't like flowers. And you decorate all the time. When you do die, I'm just going to decorate the room of every holiday. It's just going to be a mishmash of all the holidays because that's what you like. But then it stuck with me.
So now that's what we're doing for her birthday party at a funeral home.
Oh, I love that big turkey.
When people arrive, they will walk through. Each section will be a different holiday. We added some fun games like hopscotch to heaven. And then it will end at Halloween, which is my mom's favorite holiday.
Here, carry your precious gems here. It weighs a million pounds.
My legs are my best feature, so I wanted them hanging out of my casket.
She did not want a regular casket. Of course not. No, she wanted a red, sparkly one.
I love it. Look at it.
It's metal flake.
It's beautiful.
So we had to actually get it wrapped, like how they wrap a car.
I felt like the red would make my legs look better.
You always find something to make your legs look better.
I love it. Look how pretty it is.
Let's welcome the woman of the hour.
She's alive.
I'm alive.
She's alive, and we hope for a long time.
Well,
right?
Thank you.
So everyone have a good time, and then we'll read some eulogies.
Uh-oh. Great.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming to my funeral. Thank you for coming.
Oh, I would have missed it.
Thanks for coming to my funeral.
Mom, stop saying that. It's your
she
birthday.
She gets mad that I say it's my funeral. But is this a funeral? It's not like...
It's not.
I'm calling it a living funeral party, but Christina's calling it a birthday party at a funeral home, which really sounds stupid.
My way is much better.
Happy birthday!
Finally saying happy birthday, it's fun! Are you shocked?
This seems appropriate.
Totally.
What?
They're my pants.
I think everybody was a little bit taken back by what you had on.
Did you notice that your pants matched the legs in the casket?
I was so exhausted from decorating, I just grabbed something.
Oh,
I
swear. My ass.
I swear.
I should have showed up in all red suit like the devil for your party.
Where'd the red casket
go? Oh, we had it made. If that's her casket, that's what she will be buried in.
Thank God.
I swear to God, she wanted a red, sparkly casket. Wait till you see it.
Oh my God. Ew. It felt very strange walking into a funeral home and seeing all the decorations and a casket at the front, but it's not that surprising for Kathy and Christina to pull something like this off.
Doesn't it really look like her legs?
Listen, I'll give them credit. They throw phenomenal parties. I mean, the legs looked beautiful because I did it, but other than that, it's just weird.
It's been an up and down roller coaster.
Yes.
Making me throw this party. And now I have to give a eulogy.
That's right.
Yeah.
Hey, Renee.
Are you gonna read something?
Do I have to?
I would like it if you did. If I can get through mine.
The thing I'm looking forward most for this party is to hear what people say in eulogies. And I can't wait to hear Christina's eulogy about me.
Are we ready? The anticipation. I don't want to even do this right now. Writing a eulogy was hard. You know, it's a lot on someone to have to tell the person you love everything that you want to say. Just thinking about this whole thing has really got me stressed out and worried.
So I have asked a few people to get up and say some words about my mom.
Uh-oh, I'm in trouble now.
So on behalf of Christina and Carly, I'd like to extend a very sincere thank you to all of you who have joined today in the funeral services and visitation for Kathy and all the souls of the faithfully departed. Through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
We never knew if you would show up in jeans and a t-shirt or a chicken costume.
That's so true.
I reached out to a bunch of people and said, text me and tell me your first thoughts when you think Kathy.
Oh, no.
Gene Simmons.
May she rest in peace. Oh, and I forgot one more thing. Thank God the Wicked Witch is dead. Thank you, ladies. Thank you.
I love Uncle Joe.
So do I.
Okay, here we go. Those of you who knew my mom understand nothing about her life was normal. From the time I can remember, my mom always celebrated events with large, over-the-top parties. In my eyes, she was the Da Vinci of party planning.
Stop crying.
Shut up.
She's alive.
Did you write anything?
I'm embarrassed.
Yeah, shut the hell up.
Yeah, embarrassed. Okay.
You know, I lost my dad, and I never said things that I wanted to say to him. So, with my mom, I knew this was my chance to tell her. I didn't want to have those regrets. And my advice to anybody out there is, do not make the mistake and wait. Because we all hope that one day we will see them again and that we will be able to tell them. But you don't know, so.
When you live a life, in the end, it doesn't matter what you do as your profession, how much money you made, what your status was, what matters who you were as a person. My mom gave and gave, even when she didn't have it. She was pure greatness with a genuine heart.
When I was listening to Christina's eulogy, it was just like, wow, she got it. She got the message that I was always trying to give her. She's turned out so good, and she's got such a great heart, and she's just good.
It didn't work right, but I mean, I love you.
Okay, I guess I have to say something now. Well, I'm alive. What can I say? Who gets a chance to say thank you to everyone at their funeral? I have one other thing to say. Christina can't get close enough to me. So I have a place in a wall in a mausoleum, and I have bought Christina the spot right next to me.
No, you didn't! Are you kidding me?
So she could stay close to me forever.
Oh, my God!
I was literally the happiest I've ever been. I knew my mom would go in with my dad, and I was like, now we're gonna be in the wall next to her.
No. Not we,
yeah.
You.
No,
it's a two-person.
It's a two-person crypt, you're in there too. We're all gonna spend eternity together.
Please?
People buy their spots all the time before they're dead.
Okay, well, I don't wanna buy my spot.
Well, don't worry, mom bought it for us. I think it was the best gift in the world.
Is this serious or a lie?
No, it's a certificate. You're right next to me. We'll all be together.
My mother got my sister a mausoleum plot next to her, which all I'm thinking is like, thanks a lot.
Can we sing to her real quick, guys? Happy birthday to you.
Cha-cha-cha.
The party overall, I believe, was a huge success.
I agree.
To be honest with you, I have learned everything I know from my mom. She's taught me how to cook, she's taught me how to clean, she's taught me how to parent, she's taught me how to live on a day-to-day basis. So I feel like I'm my mom all over again.
You're right. We all turn into our mothers.
Yay! I love you all so much!